Uh-oh, Gordon's got some missile problem. Ooh. Thomas the Tank Engine and Friends, Australia, Series 1. Gordon's Whistle, Australian made. Gordon was cross. Why should Henry have new tubes? I never would think his first ones in his new shape would be all a fine fiddle. But, well, the new ones, I wish I could have them, but can't have them because mine are fine. And there's another thing, he whistles still too much. You can't do it loudly at stations. We do it for safety, said Henry, and saying hello. That's what we do, but whistling loudly at stations, we only whistle when we start with a train. Well, at least you're with us again. We can all work together. Hey, where are your arches when you had your new shape?
They
weren't given to me. As I was on television. It was a long time ago in the past.
I still like your happy whistling, Henry.
Face, Percy. Later on, Henry took a slow train and presently stopped at Branch Line Station.
Hello, Henry, said Edward. You look all better with new tubes. I was pleased to hear your happy whistle yesterday.
Thank you, Edward, said Henry. I had those tubes from the Crystal Girls Railway in the Second World. Something?
Why, yes. And it's getting louder.
That's Gordon's whistle, I suppose, but he never whistles like that. They heard him pass the Forest Railway. One minute, the loudness of the whistle was near, the next it was far and gone. I did tell Gordon about not whistling loudly at stations, which is unexpected to anyone. Gordon came screeching to the Greendale Railway. The noise was awful to anyone's ears. He didn't want to stop the puffing Billy. He knew he wouldn't like it. The workman called to knock his whistle valve into place, and there was silence. Gordon snuck into the shed. He was glad it was empty. The others came in later. "Don't say I didn't tell you," said Henry.